Hello students, so let's understand this question first. A small block of mass 0.1 kg lies on the fixed inclined plane PQ, which makes an angle theta with the horizontal. A horizontal force of 1 newton acts on the block through its center of mass as shown in the figure. The block remains stationary if, in which of the following conditions the block remains stationary. हमें ये पता करना है, ठीक है? ये block, ये inclined plane है और इसके ऊपर एक block रखा है of mass 0.1 kg. एंड उसके ऊपर एक फोर्स लगा हुआ है 1 न्यूटन एंड द एंगल ऑफ इंक्लिनेशन जो है इंक्लाइंड प्लेन का दैट इज थीटा. ठीक है, तो वी विल राइट डाउन द गिवन थिंग्स. फर्स्टली व्हाट वी हैव बीन गिवन, वी नो दैट एंगल ऑफ इंक्लिनेशन ऑफ द इंक्लाइंड प्लेन इज थीटा. एंगल ऑफ इंक्लिनेशन इज थीटा. फोर्स ऑन द ब्लॉक इज ऑफ 1 न्यूटन. Okay, now and now we will draw the free body diagram for this. We will be drawing the free body diagram. So like this, there is a block of mass 0.1 kg and a force F equal to 1 Newton is acting in this direction. Okay, 1 Newton is acting in this direction. And its mass is 0.1 kg. Okay, now let's start with our solution. So we'll be working on this free body diagram only. What will happen? Let's draw one more figure. Let's say we have this block. This is our block. And the force on this block, as we know, in this direction is 1 Newton. Its mass is 0.1 kg. So an mg will also be acting on this in this direction. And a normal will be acting along this direction. Okay. We know this angle. Is theta. This angle is theta. If this angle is theta, then this will be mg sin theta and this will be mg cos theta. If we resolve this force also, the given the external force also, then we'll get 1 cos theta up the incline and 1 sin theta opposite to the नॉर्मल. ठीक है, ये 1 sin theta और 1 cos mg cos theta जो फोर्सेस हैं ये तो नॉर्मल को बैलेंस कर देंगे. अब हमें जो क्वेश्चन पूछा है वो डिपेंड करता है अलोंग द इंक्लाइन फोर्सेस पे, यानी कि mg sin theta 1 cos theta. एक फोर्स इस पर और लगेगा क्योंकि हमें फ्रिक्शन की बात करनी है इसके अंदर. तो हम मान लेते हैं कि अप द इंक्लाइन एक फ्रिक्शन भी एफ भी लग रहा है. ठीक है, तो अप द इंक्लाइन अगर हम इक्वेशन लिखते हैं तो हमें मिलेगा एफ प्लस 1 cos theta is equal to mg sin theta. Okay, and f should be equal to mg sin theta minus 1 cos theta, right? अगर मैं m की वैल्यू 0.1 और g की वैल्यू 10 रखता हूं जैसा कि दिया हुआ है, तो what I'll be getting, this is 0.1 into 10 sin theta minus 1 cos theta, which will give me F equal to sin theta minus cos theta. ठीक है, this will be our basic equation जिसको हम use करने वाले हैं to find the solution and to work on these options. Okay, so firstly we will see theta is equals to 45 degree is our one of the options. How can this be? If friction is zero, if this friction becomes zero, let's write it down here. If F is zero, then sin theta minus cos theta will become zero, which will give me sin theta equal to cos theta. And this happens only when theta is 45 degrees. Okay, so we have our option number one. Option number A, Okay, now option, what option B says? Option B says theta is greater than 45 degree and a frictional force acts on the block towards P. Let's read C and D also. If theta is greater than 45 degree and frictional force acts on the blocks towards Q, and theta is less than 45 degree and frictional force acts on the block towards Q. So let us assume that a force of friction is acting towards Q. Q is on the upward side and P is on the downward side. We'll assume that F is acting towards the Q. If F is acting towards Q, then we know if F is acting towards Q, then we know F should be greater than 0. If this is greater than 0, from this equation sine theta minus cos theta should be greater than 0, or we can say sine theta should be greater than cos theta. This infers theta should be greater than 45 degree. Okay, this will happen when the theta is 45 degree and force of friction is acting on the acting towards the Q. There is one more option. When the frictional force acts on the block towards P, when the force is acting towards P, F should be less than 0. F should be less than 0. Let's see that also. If F is acting towards P, then F should be less than 0, which says sine theta minus cos theta should be less than 0. That is, sine theta should be less than cos theta and theta should be less than 45 degree. So let's see which of our options are matching. We'll see that theta equals to 45 degree is matching with option number A. Theta is greater than 45 degree if the force is towards Q is matching with option number B. And theta is less than 45 degree if F is acting towards P. For P, we are having B option. Theta is greater than 45 degree, so this is not matching with our options. Correct. Then the correct answer we are having is A and C. So let's write down our correct answer. We are having correct options as F is for F greater than 0 towards Q. Theta should be greater than 45 degree, and for F equal to 0, theta should be equal to 45 degree, which means option A and C are correct. So this was the solution to this question. Thank you.